12 proven tactics to make vet trips less stressful for your cat. Welcome to the Cat and Dog House, where we help cat and dog parents better understand their pets. I'm Susan Nilsson, and in this video, I'm going to be talking about how to make it a bit easier to get a scared cat to the veterinarian. According to the American Animal Hospital Association, a staggering 58% of cat parents believe their feline companions hate vet visits. And it's not just the cats who find it stressful. 38% of cat owners also feel anxious at the mere thought of bringing their precious feline in for a checkup. Maybe this explains why a lot more pet owners, 79%, take their dogs to the vet compared to their feline counterparts, 48%. So if you're a cat owner who dreads taking your furry friend to the vet, know that you are not alone. Fortunately, with some tips and tricks, it is possible to make a potentially traumatic experience far less stressful for both of you. Here are my 12 recommendations. Number 1. One of the best ways to ensure a smooth veterinary visit is to start preparing your cat early on. This means getting her used to being handled and examined, even when there is no immediate need for a checkup. You can practice this at home by gently inspecting your cat's mouth, eyes, ears, and under her tail. You can also familiarize her with gentle poking and prodding of her sides and abdomen. By making this type of handling and physical contact a regular part of your cat's routine, she will be more comfortable with it when the time comes for an actual vet visit. Number 2. The carrier is likely going to be your cat's most feared item in this entire process, so choosing the right one is crucial. Choose a carrier that provides enough room for your cat to stand, turn around, and lie down comfortably. You might want to opt for a sturdy carrier made of hard plastic or metal, as opposed to soft-sided carriers that can easily collapse. This will help your cat feel more secure and prevent escape attempts. Avoid carriers with a lot of holes or mesh, as they can be stress-inducing for cats who like to hide in confined spaces. Number 3. One of the biggest stressor for cats during a vet visit is being confined to their carrier. But if you prepare in advance so your cat can travel quite happily in her carrier, it can significantly reduce the stress of vet trips for everyone involved. In an emergency, this could be a life-saving advantage. To ease your cat's anxiety about her cat carrier, it is important to build positive associations with it well in advance. Making your cat's carrier as inviting as possible so she wants to spend time in it is one of the first steps in making vet visits a less negative experience. Number 4. Once you're on the move, try to avoid swinging the carrier or making any sudden movements that may cause jarring. At the same time, try to avoid bumping it against objects or walls. Ideally, hold the carrier against your body with both arms underneath, rather than using just one hand on the handle. Number 5. Now that your cat is a little more comfortable with all aspects of her carrier, it's time to introduce the car. This is another important step that can reduce anxiety and make the car ride to the veterinary clinic less stressful. You can introduce the car gradually to your cat by placing her carrier in the car for 1 to 2 minutes with the car door open. After several sessions of that, you can start closing the car door, as long as she is calm and relaxed about the whole thing. Next, familiarize her with the engine sounds by briefly turning the car on and then off again over a period of a few days. The next step is to go for a few short car rides, adding a few minutes each time. Watch your cat for fear or stress signs, including dilated pupils, flattened ears, stiff posture, hiding, excessive vocalizing, or attempting to escape. If you notice anything like this, slow down, backtrack, and proceed more gradually. To learn more about your cat's body language, make sure you download my free cat body language cheat sheet made easy, link below. Number 6. Getting your cat to the vet involves not just physical transportation but also managing her emotional well-being during the journey. Creating a comfortable environment is the first step. Start by placing a favorite cat bed or blanket inside the carrier to help your cat feel more at home. It's also best to line the floor of the carrier with a familiar blanket or bedding she has already slept on so it carries her scent. You can even go a step further and add in a t-shirt you've slept in or worn to the gym. These familiar scents will help make her feel more secure. Number 7. Sprays that mimic natural cat pheromones, such as Fellaway or Comfort Zone, can have a calming effect on cats. See links below. Before your trip, Give the inside of your cat's carrier a quick spritz and see if it helps. Although not all cats will respond, it can't hurt and is worth a try. Number 8. Similar to calming sprays, you can also use a calming collar that releases pheromones over time, link below. This can be particularly useful for longer journeys or if your cat is prone to extreme anxiety. Number 9. Believe it or not, there is music specifically designed for cats to help them relax and feel more at ease. Playing this type of music during the journey can help soothe your cat's nerves, and I've used it to great effect on a number of occasions. See playlist below. Number 10. In addition to playing calming music, it's important to also try to minimize any sudden or loud noises during the journey. For example, avoid playing loud music or honking the horn unnecessarily, and keep the car windows closed. Number 11. If your cat is anything like mine, she will want to look out of the window during the car journey. Other cats prefer to be able to see their owners and don't care what is outside the window. However, some cats will prefer to have their carrier covered during transportation, giving them a sense of security. If your cat is one of those, try using a towel or blanket to cover her carrier, making sure there is sufficient ventilation. Number 12. Even if you are feeling anxious about the vet visit yourself, try not to project that onto your cat. Cats can pick up on our emotions and may become more stressed as a result. So try to stay calm and reassure your cat by talking gently to her. In my next video, I'll be talking about how you can help keep your cat calm once you arrive at the vet's office, link below. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe for more videos on cat behavior. For more in-depth content about cat behavior, check us out at catanddoghouse.com/cats.